So yeah, let's do it. So who am I? My name is Christina Padilla. I'm the Sustainability Engagement Coordinator at the IUPUI Office of Sustainability, or IUPUI Sustainability, as you might also hear it be called. We work really closely with Danni and with the Indiana Sustainability Development Program, especially around this time of year when we start promoting the program applications being open. Your other presenter that I just mentioned is Danni Schaust. She is the ISDP program manager. Fun fact, Danni is actually a graduate of IUPUI. She earned her MPA right here and went on to get a job at the IU Bloomington Office of Sustainability. We will also hear from Miranda Frausto. She is an undergraduate student at IUPUI studying sustainable management and policy. She'll actually be graduating this May. She, as she will share, has been a part of the program for 2 years. So she can definitely share a lot about her long experience with ISDP. And lastly, you will hear from Jonathan. Jonathan Lewis is currently in his senior year studying sustainable management and policy. He is in the accelerated master's program and plans to stay at the O'Neill School of Public and Environmental Affairs to do a sustainability master's degree starting next year. So with that being said, again, just want to reiterate, drop your questions at any point and we will address them all after Jonathan finishes presenting. And yeah, we're really glad you're here. So Danni, take it away.
Great. Well, thank you, Christina. I'm going to get my slides up really quick. But thanks, everybody, for joining today. I recognize a few names and faces on the call, which is really exciting. Just a quick thumbs up if you can see my slides. Awesome. Okay, great. Well, I'll just go ahead and jump right into it. So we leave plenty of time for questions. And so Jonathan and Miranda can tell you about their experience in the program. So just a quick overview of what we'll be talking about today. I'll be giving a quick overview of what exactly is ISDP, our current partners, some important program deadlines, and what it means to be a good applicant for this program and how you can put together a good application over these next couple weeks. All right, so this is kind of our general recruitment slide that I always use. I think some of us are in this photo with different haircuts, which is pretty fun. But this is the ISDP program. So we are looking for students from all IU campuses, any major undergrad or graduate student to apply. This is a full-time summer position. So we do expect students are available to work 40 hours a week during the summer, and you do receive a scholarship in exchange for your time. So it's a really great opportunity if you're looking to get some experience in the sustainability and climate profession, if you're looking to get more experience, you know, explore different career options. It's a really great opportunity for you to get your hands dirty and get some direct experience. And we are accepting applications right now until February 19th. So you've got about two and a half weeks to pull together an application. But let's get more into what exactly we're looking for. So a little bit more about the program first, though. We are funded by the McKinney Family Foundation. We are focused on sustainability and climate action. And this is different from other internship experiences in that we're really trying to get you real world hands-on experience in sustainability and climate work. So you'll really be getting to do some awesome high level stuff. Jonathan and Miranda can tell you what exactly their experience has been with the program, but it is different from some other programs in that you do get to really do some leadership and high level experiences. And these are just the broad goals of our program overall. We're trying to not only help students get direct experience, but also build capacity for businesses, cities and towns, and nonprofits so they have more jobs and that they have stronger connections to climate action and sustainability. And then stage three, which is new this year, will be actually implementing climate action plans from cities that have already drafted these plans. So really excited about this program. It's in our third summer and our third year of partnering with ERI and with ICLEI. So it's going to be really cool to see what happens. So some important program deadlines to be aware of. Right now we are accepting applications until February 19th, and we plan to begin interviews shortly afterwards. In previous years, we have tried to make offers to students before spring break, but of course there's not spring break this year. However, we do plan to make all of our offers to candidates by the middle of March. At that point, if you were to receive an offer from the program, we would send you information about what is needed from you and how to get your scholarship. So students will receive their scholarship by early May. And we do have what is called boot camp. It is a required training for all students. Since you don't have to be a sustainability major, we do have a required training for everyone to attend to make sure that we're all on the same page, that everybody has a clear understanding of what they're supposed to do this summer, and to make sure you have the skills, tools, and resources you need to be successful. And then at that point, you will start your placements with your organization in late May, early June. And then you'll have constant communication with me. I will host at least 2 weekly check-ins over Zoom with students. And we do ask that students submit weekly reports. I'm happy to do one-on-ones. So you get constant communication with me if you get into the program. You'll be like, oh, Danny's emailing me. We have another meeting again. But we just want to make sure that you're supported and that you're having a great experience. So if you get into the program, you'll get to know me very well. So what's expected from you? So just a few things to be aware of if you're planning to apply. You do have to be a current student with at least 1 semester left. So if you're graduating in August of this year, you are still eligible, but unfortunately, if you are graduating in May 2021, you won't be able to participate. It's just a requirement of our program that you have to be currently enrolled in the program or in a program to participate. It is, like I mentioned, a full-time commitment, so you are expected to be able to work full-time over the summer for 10 to 12 weeks between May and August. And you don't have to be an O'Neill SPIA major to participate. You just have to have a passion and interest to work in the sustainability field after you graduate. So what makes a good applicant? Well, what we're looking for is your standard cover letter and resume, which it's pretty standard, but we do recommend that you do reach out to the career development staff at your individual school for advice so they can take a peek at your resume. And if you're selected for an interview, I also recommend utilizing them to do a mock interview if you've never done one. It's very, very helpful, and they can give you feedback about how to improve. Aside from that, we do ask some other questions that are maybe a little different from other applications you've done in the past. So while we are hiring for 29 different organizations, we do ask that you select your top 5 organizations that you are most interested in working for. So that will require you to spend a little bit of time on our website, look at those job applications or those job descriptions, and see which ones you're most interested in and select those on your application. We also ask for a few essays on the application as well. These aren't to test your knowledge so much as they are to get a sense for your communication style, what your passion is, and so we can understand what your baseline knowledge is for sustainability and climate action. We also ask for professional references, which sector you're interested in, if you have a geographic preference, some things like that just to keep in mind. If you'd really like to stay in the central Indiana area during the summer, we just want to know that so we can try to keep that in mind when we are looking at your application. And while we're hopeful to be back to in-person placements this summer, we don't yet know. However, if we are in person this summer, then we will send out information about a housing scholarship and relocation funding that you could apply for if you do have to move for the summer. As far as the resilience cohort, so ISDP and the resilience cohort are the same application, but for these positions, we're really looking for some specific skills and knowledge. So we're really looking for a demonstrated attention to detail and data management, some familiarity with the science behind climate change, if you've got experience with community engagements, environmental economics, benefit cost analysis, those kinds of things are really helpful. Even if you have a really strong math or science background, we found that those candidates are very strong candidates for this, these types of positions as well. So a few tips, get your application in early. You know, if you've had a chance to review and revise your resume and cover letter, go ahead and submit it. Really, we recommend getting that in early because we are actually reviewing candidates as they come in. Something we're doing differently this year is we're actually doing an anonymous review of our candidates. So we are looking specifically at qualifications. We're not looking at names or geographic location to see if that impacts the type of candidates that we're hiring. So I do recommend getting your application in early. Remember that it is mandatory to attend the bootcamp in May. Those are the dates. The bootcamp will be virtual again this year, so you won't have to come to any specific campus to attend. We would send out more information on that if you were to get into the program. And again, just really do some research on the positions that you're most interested in. You can only select five, so make sure you spend some time reviewing what they're looking for and what you're most interested in. So how to apply? So this is a screenshot from our website. If you type this URL into Google or whatever web browser that you use, it'll bring up our Sustain IU website. You can see here, there's actually a tab at the top of the page for Indiana Climate Fellows. If you click on that, it'll bring up this heading. And then I recommend clicking, I actually recommend when you are on our website, clicking on the student tab. So I'll see if I can bring this back up for you. There we go. So there is a tab on the left side of the page. If you click on ISDP students, it will bring up a link to the application and all 29 job descriptions on our website. You can also Google the name of the program and it should be the first thing that comes up as well. But that's where you need to go to fill out the application and look at the job descriptions. And then if you're not eligible to apply, or if you're really looking for other types of opportunities, maybe you're looking for a full-time job, I also recommend applying. I recommend joining our LinkedIn group. We post internships and job opportunities on this LinkedIn group throughout the year. So even beyond the summer fellowships, we do have lots of different opportunities in Indiana and really across the Midwest that are shared with us. So I do recommend joining that group as well. And I will turn it over to Jonathan and Miranda at this point so they can tell you about their experience. But I will leave my contact info up here for a second if you'd like to shoot me a message, and I will put it in the chat as well.
Hey, Danny, there was a question in the chat from Jonathan about will we only be looked at by our top five preferences, or could we receive offers from ones outside of your top five listed?
Great question. So while we do ask students to select the top five positions they're most interested in, it is possible that you could be considered for other positions as well. Great question, Jonathan. Yes, especially for the resilience cohort, a lot of those positions will be pretty much identical. It'll just be a different community that you would be in. So if you really want to work in local government, but you don't really care what city it is, we can talk about that if you're selected for an interview. That's something that comes up every year. So I would just say, be open to opportunities. And if you have a specific preference for a type of experience that you're looking for, you know, indicate that in your resume, indicate that in your application. And if you're selected for an interview, let me know. I'm happy to, I want to put you where you want to be, basically. That's what I'm here to do.
All right. Thank you so much, Danni. Next, we're going to hear from Miranda Frausto. Take it over, Mandy.
Hello, everyone. I'm going to pull up my slides. Let me see. Oops, sorry about that. Okay. Let's go back. Okay. Hello, everyone. For those of you I haven't met, I am Miranda, and I'm here to talk a little bit about what ISDP looked like for me. I think, like Christina mentioned, I've done it for the past 2 years, so I actually was a part of the resilience cohort in 2019 and in 2020, specifically for the city of Cornwall. So a little bit about me. This is already mentioned, but I'm a senior. I'm studying sustainable management and policy and getting a sustainable technology certificate, and I'll be graduating in May. And here's a little bit of my background just to give a little bit more context as to my ISDP placement. So in high school, I did a little bit of volunteer experience with the Promise Project, which was a youth-led organization that worked directly with city officials to pass a climate resolution. So for about 2 years, we met with city councilors and Mayor Brainerd from the city of Carmel to pass this climate resolution, and it passed in 2017. So that was my first experience with sustainability. And then I came to IUPUI that same year, and I got an internship with the Office of Sustainability, and I've been working for them for almost 4 years now. And I've held a couple different roles, sustainable waste management intern, food waste reduction intern, and now I'm the campus kitchen co-director and community engagement associate. And like I mentioned, I was an ISDP fellow in 2019 and 2020. So how I learned about ISDP, in 2018, I was a freshman, and that was the first time I'd heard about it since I had just started IUPUI, and through social media and word of mouth. It's kind of funny, like for sustainability students, like this is kind of like the mother load of like internships. So like we're always talking about it when ISDP season comes around. But I put in here my decision to apply. I put self-doubt because my freshman year, I convinced myself not to apply. I didn't think I had the experience, or I just convinced myself that I wouldn't be a good fit or I wouldn't be placed. And I was just being too hard on myself. But I put that in there because I really wish I had, because the worst thing that could have happened was that I got some resume, cover letter, interview experience. And the best thing that could have happened was I had been placed, in an internship for an extra year. But I decided to apply in 2019, not only because I wanted to do ISDP and further my sustainability experience, but the city of Carmel had become a partner for ISDP. And I was like, I really want to continue my work with them since I had worked with them so heavily in high school and kind of continue that climate leadership at the city level. So I decided to apply. And I spent a lot of time on my resume and cover letter and making sure I'm tailoring my experiences and my background to the exact job description. Like Danni talked about, you really want to make sure that you're honing in on your relevant experience. You don't need to share everything you've ever done, but really making sure you have a clear understanding of the job description and applying that to what you write about in your resume and your cover letter. And also, like Danni mentioned, you want to make sure that the positions that you are interested in align with your passion and your experience. So really think about, what I want to get out of this internship, what I want to get out of it for my future, and, just spend a lot of time thinking about what that looks like for you individually. So I, did the resume, cover letter, interview experience, and I was placed with the city of Carmel in 2019, and it just worked out well. It was a good match because I really wanted to work for them. And like I mentioned, I spent a lot of time thinking about how my experiences apply to the position. So in 2019 for the resilience cohort, which the city of Carmel was a partner for, they were looking for interns to do a greenhouse gas inventory. I had never done a greenhouse gas inventory, and I probably hadn't even heard of one before then. But I was able to think about, okay, these are my experiences that apply and will help me be successful in this role. Even if I don't know exactly how to do it, I'm going to learn along the way. And that's the case with almost any internship. You're always going to learn along the way. So don't convince yourself just because you don't know everything that you wouldn't be a good fit. So like I mentioned, in 2019, I did technically 4 greenhouse gas inventories for the city of Carmel. I'll try not to get too technical, but the things that I worked on the most, like Danni mentioned, understanding the science background is especially important for resilience cohort students. You're talking about greenhouse gases, the greenhouse gas effect, and how communities are creating emissions and how to reduce them. So having that understanding so that not only you understand it, but are able to communicate it with others, especially in the greenhouse gas inventory process. We worked a lot with external partners, community partners, utility providers. So you have to be able to explain what you're working on and why it's important and why they should give you this data, which was the whole essence of the greenhouse gas inventory process, collecting the right data from the right sector so that you can analyze the community's emissions and figure out where emissions are coming from, you know, transportation, energy, et cetera, to get a better idea of what the community can work on. And so, and then you have that information over weeks. It takes a long time to gather all that data. And then you write a report. And that was essentially what I worked on when I was the 2019 Resilience Cohort Fellow for the City of Carmel. And then I reapplied in 2020 to work with the City of Carmel again to work on the Climate Action Plan, which was taking the results of the greenhouse gas inventory work that I had done in the past, but applying it to, you know, what we can do about it. So really narrowing down the strategies and planning and initiatives that will make sure that the City of Carmel reduces their emissions effectively. And oh yeah, I forgot to mention. So I worked mostly this summer on community engagement. So public workshops, stakeholder workshops, youth workshops, surveys, et cetera, to get a better sense of the community sentiments, perspectives, et cetera, in composing a climate action plan. So that was a little bit about my experience, but if you have any questions about like technical stuff, please let me know. I'm happy to elaborate. So my last thoughts, challenge yourself. You know, it's not an easy internship. IACP is meant to be challenging, but you want that because you want to be able to grow, you know, your experiences, your resume, your portfolio. So I would highly encourage that for yourself or anyone who may be interested in IACP to do it, you know, to really grow. And you get technical skills out of it. You know, I didn't know how to do a greenhouse gas inventory or climate action planning, but now that's something I can put on my resume and talk about my experience with for future employers. And I got some industry experience. I worked directly, you know, in the public sector. Well, back when it wasn't virtual, you know, I would literally go to City Hall and like pass by Mayor Brainerd and be like, hey, how's it going? So, you know, it's really good to get a sense of what it's like to work in a city or, you know, the private sector or the nonprofit sector, you know, so you can kind of narrow down a little bit like what kind of career path you're thinking for yourself. So my advice is if you're interested, apply. Don't be like me and not apply because you don't think, you know, you have the right experience or background. Like I said, the worst thing that can happen is you get a lot of good experience with writing your resume and cover letter and interview, et cetera. And the best thing that can happen is that, you know, you do IACP, you have, you know, really great experience working full time in something that hopefully you're really interested in. And I'll also mention it's a really good chance to figure out what you do and don't like. You know, through my process, I learned I worked a lot with data gathering and management, and I realized, you know, that's great. And I'm glad that I got that experience. But what I really love to do in my sustainability career is the engagement, education, outreach portion of sustainability. So that's something I learned about myself that I can apply to what I choose for my career in the future. So with that, you know, spending time deciding what positions you want and what you want to get out of it, and, you know, really think about what skills you think would be pertinent to what you want to do or partners you would really like to connect with, you know, in the state of Indiana. Spend a lot of time on your resume, cover letter, interview. That preparation really shows in resumes and cover letters, that extra time. And even coming to this webinar, you're spending, you know, an hour of your day because you're interested and you want to learn more. And that shows when you, you know, when people are reviewing your application that they can see the extra time that people put in, especially in an interview. Coming prepared really makes you stand out. And I put seek help. You know, there are tons of resources for resume review, cover letter review, interview preparation, et cetera. And, you know, investing that time is really worthwhile. And if you're interested in learning more about IACP, specifically the Resilience Cohort, please let me know. I'll put my email in the chat. I'm happy to help and, you know, review anything for you. And yeah, I think that's all I had. But yeah, let me know if you have any other questions and always feel free to reach out to me.
Thank you so much, Miranda. You made a lot of really great points. I remember when I graduated from IUPUI in 2017, it was really jarring to me to transition from a student lifestyle to kind of a full-time workforce lifestyle. And so this is what really sets ISDP apart, in my opinion, is that you get to test out what it's like to go out and work full time and have real responsibility, just like you will after you graduate, but with that added kind of like oversight and resources that ISDP provides. So thank you so much, Miranda. Up next, we have Jonathan Lewis. Jonathan, take it away.
Yes, I don't know if I can follow with Miranda. That was a great job on her, but I'll do my best. So I don't have slides. You know, this is just gonna be me talking, but in case you didn't know, I'm Jonathan Lewis. I'm studying sustainability management and policy. And like Miranda, actually, I'm also going for a sustainable technology certificate. So a little bit about me, I guess, additionally, is currently I'm a senior and I've had ISDP for about 1 year. So I guess my first year, my freshman year, I applied for ISDP. And so this kind of goes with Miranda's point. I applied, right? And I thought, you know what? Worst happens. That's okay. I did not get it, but I used what I learned from that experience and I made sure to ask Danni. I'm like, hey, can you tell me some tips on what I did in my interview that I could have done better? Or what are some things that, you know, a real ISDP intern or good applicant would be kind of needing, for example? And so she provided that information and I actually used that in future interviews, such as now I'm the energy intern for the Office of Sustainability, but I used that information for my interview there. And I also used that information for my interview to get my to get the ISDP internship I had last summer, which was with Hillenbrand. And going with Miranda's point even further, sorry, Miranda, I'm totally piggybacking off all of you, but I'd probably say, look at the positions that both interest you, as well as the ones that you think might challenge you and help you further progress your technical skills. It's really kind of a big deal. And this is a great place for you to both learn what you want to do and what you might not want to do, because it's better to do that in an internship than, you know, get a full-time job and be like, I hate this, you know, because you're in a full-time job. You don't want to do that. No. So about Hillenbrand though, I gained quite a lot of experience. I did not know much, I will admit. I did not have much technical experience. This was a global manufacturing company. Global is in like global all around. They had places in India, Canada, all over. And so I was supposed to be working with them. However, I learned quite a bit about overall working with a company in a business and how they really go about doing things. So I worked on sustainability reporting, you know, looking at, for anybody who's familiar with ASHI or STARS report, or I guess another one might be TCFD, CD, pretty much a bunch of different sustainability reports telling you how sustainable a company is. I worked a lot with that, as well as I worked on a greenhouse gas emissions report for the company, or rather telling them, hey, this is what you guys could do regarding this. But overall, it's a really great opportunity. I don't have much to say other than, honestly, ISDP is a wonderful opportunity for you to gain plenty of experiences that will benefit you in the long run and teach you a lot of things. I mean, I will admit, I'm probably not touching on as much as I did learn. You know, and that's kind of how it is. You learn a lot, but you don't realize you learn a lot, if that makes sense. Like, you gain all these skills and you're like, oh, boom, I can do all this and I can do that. But you don't really think, oh, I can do all this, because, you know, you're just like, oh, it's just another day at the office, you know? So I probably talked long enough, but overall, I just want to say, if you're interested in an ISDP and if you're interested in really growing, you know, your sustainability career, or you even have a small interest in sustainability, I highly recommend applying, even if you possibly don't get it, which I'm sure everyone here, you know, you guys, I'm sure, want to learn all this. You guys are probably going to get something, or I don't know, get an interview. I don't know. I'm not one to say though, but regardless, it's a great experience and it's a great chance for you to really grow. So yeah, that is kind of all I have. Oh, and I am applying again because I really enjoyed the experience. So yeah, well, that's all I got.
I'll add that to Jonathan. Like, I've been working in sustainability for a decade now, for 10 years, all in high. I still learn new things. Like, once a week, it feels like, you know, new technology, new ways to do things. I mean, yeah. And what's important though, is like, you know, being able to like somehow track or try to verbalize what that learning is, because when you go to apply for other jobs or do other things, like actually sit down and think about, like, what have I learned and how do I communicate in that a way that like my potential employer might value, even though, like, you know, it might be hard to explain. So
thank you, Jonathan. And if anybody has any questions, feel free to drop them in the chat. We might have lost some questions when we ended the other Zoom call. So if you had dropped a question and now it's gone, please drop it again. Or you can actually just unmute yourself. There's just enough of us that we can have kind of a casual conversation right now. But I guess to kick things off, I had a question for Jonathan. So you said that, like, when you went into it, you really didn't have a lot of experience. And by the time that you came out, like, now you have so much experience with these different, you know, sustainability reporting programs. How did that impact, I guess, your confidence? And, you know, how long did it take for you to feel like you were really picking up on what you were supposed to be doing and, you know?
Well, I will be completely honest. You know, it kind of felt like, hey, when I looked back on it, just like when you look back on anything, probably you think, you know what, maybe I could have done a little bit better. But still, I learned quite a lot from this. It definitely helped my confidence overall. You know, now I've been able to actually use my experience. You know, currently I'm working with Jessica Davis on a greenhouse gas estimate for the NCAA's March Madness, which is really quite fun. I wouldn't have been able to do that without this experience, which is very nice. You know, it's very good to be able to say, this led me to point A, led me to point B. So, yeah, you know, it definitely has helped me quite a bit to feel like I'm growing as a sustainability professional, you know, be able to say I had a full-time summer internship. And I was very lucky too. Some were canceled because, you know, they had to go virtual, of course. You know, nobody was expecting that during the pandemic. But luckily enough, I was able to do that. And I live in Chicago, so I stayed in Chicago, but I was able to do that and it worked out great. So, yeah. Hope that answered your question. I think it did.
I have a question.
Go for it.
So a few of you guys mentioned how, like, the like having the background knowledge and the science of it all is pretty important. And I personally am a freshman in exploratory studies, so I haven't done like any courses in sustainability, and like won't be before like this internship will be starting. So do you guys have resources available or that you would recommend for me to conduct for the research or anything like that?
Yeah, I would say what I always recommend, first of all, really do some research, not just into the job descriptions for the positions you're most interested in. Start there, first of all, but dig further into what those organizations do. If you're not sure, if you're not familiar with them, go to their website, look at their social media, try to find if they've got like a sustainability plan, a climate action plan, and do some research into that. For general climate resources, Jessica has a ton of them, first and foremost, but you can also look into the Indiana Climate Change Impacts Assessment if you want to understand, you know, locally, how is climate change impacting our state. The Environmental Resilience Institute has some great resources as well. There's a ton of stuff out there. It's honestly, you can easily fall down the rabbit hole. Yeah, thank you, Jessica, for typing that in there. But Purdue, they have a really great resource, the Indiana Climate Change Impacts Assessment. They're constantly putting out different reports and things so you can understand the local impact. And they're just a really great clearinghouse for that kind of stuff. But good question. Yeah, I would say I'm not a science major. I do not have a science background. I failed chemistry twice. So you certainly don't have to have a science degree. You can certainly still have a career in this and still understand the basics of climate change and science. There's also great YouTube videos out there. Project Drawdown is a really, really great one. I love their resources. So there's a lot you can do without being a science major.
Awesome. Thank you.
And like, it's, you don't have to understand at this level, like not like the nitty gritty. It's about understanding at this point, like this level, what it's about really understanding is that you have a fundamental grasp of what is causing the problem. Because if you do not understand what is causing the problem, you may suggest solutions that make the problem worse. And like, I've seen that happen to me before. Like I'll get sales calls from people who are trying to sell something to the campus. I ask them to explain the mechanism of their product. And I'm like, your product doesn't actually solve the problem, right? It's obvious to me because we know the science, we understand it, that this isn't going to fix it. So it helps me be a more critical consumer. Because especially when you work for big organizations like universities, like a Cummins, like people think you have deep pockets. That is actually not true, but people tend to think that you have deep pockets. You can just afford to like buy anything. So they're going to try to like, try to get you over on something. Right. So as the sustainability team, we are the filter for that. It's our job to bring forth only the best recommendations to the campus. And it's our job to know what's good and what isn't. And the campus doesn't really question that, right? That's our job to know that, not anybody else's.
Yeah, and if anybody is feeling like, oh, I don't know how to do a greenhouse gas inventory, I don't think that I could apply for the resilience cohort, do not worry, because ISDP, just like with any other job that you would apply for, pretty much like 75% of what you need to know, you're going to learn on the job while you're working. And you are not expected to come in having all of the answers. The point of ISDP is to develop you as a professional, and to give you the resources so that when you do graduate, you can say that you've done this before. But yeah, especially with the resilience cohort, I know that they do a lot of training in advance. They provide the fellows with a lot of resources and really help to prepare them for what they're going to need to know. So don't feel like they're just going to, you know, throw you out there in the wolves. They are going to make sure that you feel ready. And even if you get in there and then you have questions, you have so many people that you can reach out to who are going to answer anything you need, from Danni to the folks over at the Environmental Resilience Institute. So that is definitely, you know, there's a lot of people on your side.
And we don't just throw you to the wolves, right? You get to, you have the whole like sustainability team at the university behind you, essentially. Like you're like, I don't know how to do this. All right, talk to us. We'll walk you through it.
Yeah, we're here to help. We're going to push you, but we're going to help you grow, if that makes sense.
I'd also say, you don't just have to reach out to us, but you can also reach out to your own. So if you do get an internship with them, you can also reach out to your employers. So, I mean, I totally forgot to mention this, but they are all very nice. They understand that we're all interns, that most of us are undergrads, some are grads. I mean, they know that. They look at your resume, they look at this and they're like, okay, this person is this. So yeah, sure, go ahead, ask questions. It's okay for you not to know, because they'll be like, okay, here's how you do this. And even then they are still very nice, or at least they should be very nice. You know, they aren't gonna be like, listen, I need this done by XYZ date. I'm not going to help you. No, they're all really nice. They're all really great. Don't be scared or worried about them. I don't think you should. You know, I'm pretty sure they're all good. But yeah, I don't know. That's my little 2 cents.
Other questions?
Or thoughts or hesitations? Is anybody thinking about applying or has applied before?
I just have a question, and that would be if you guys have ever met an engineer in the sustainable majors. I don't know if that makes sense.
Yeah. Yeah, we've had, I think, at least 2 IUPUI engineering students do the program. So that's, yeah, certainly a good skill set to apply. That's actually something we're always looking for.
The reason why I applied is because so far I haven't seen any environmental engineer here at IUPUI. So I guess in a way I'm making my own version here. Like I said in the chat, I'm majoring in mechanical engineering and minoring in environmental science. I'm thinking in applying the certificate in sustainable technology. So again, I'm just trying to do a and that's why I had the question you guys have met.
Yeah, yeah. We've had several engineering students do the program. I actually think it's a really good skill set because you've got a lot of the technical expertise and you look at problems in a way that other students might not. So I actually think it's a really big benefit for you if you're interested in it. Because we're looking more for the way you approach problems and your passion for this work. Yes, if you have a sustainability degree or that's your background, that's great. But you don't have to have that background to be in this career. And I think a lot of people, especially as you get into your career, I've seen a lot of people pivot to sustainability and they have no formal education in sustainability. So I think if you can think about how to apply those skills in your application, I think you would actually be a really good candidate.
Yeah, I would say that it actually really sets you apart because a lot of sustainability students apply for this program and not that many engineers. And I know in the past when they've had maybe like energy engineering students, they were really well matched with what some of the partner organizations were looking for. You bring something to the table that a lot of other people who are applying don't. So I would really encourage you to go ahead and apply and, you know, what's the worst that could happen? Like Jonathan said, you don't get it and then you apply next year. And now we all know you were rooting for you and, you know, maybe you'll get it then. So that was a good question. Anyone else have any thoughts? Oh, go ahead, Santiago. Sorry.
Oh, no, I said, thank you.
Yeah, any other thoughts or hesitations? Anyone thinking about applying this year?
I hope you are, Jonathan.
Jonathan already gave it away. So Haley's applying, Kamala is applying. That's exciting, guys. Good luck. The Office of Sustainability at IUPUI is always a resource to you if you want someone to talk to about it in advance, maybe somebody to review your resume or your cover letter. Please let us help you. That's what we're here for.
I don't bite either. I have purple hair. I mean, I'm pretty approachable. I hope you're not scared.
Danny is too. Danny, I just didn't want to volunteer you without asking.
No, that's fair. And if I can't get to it quickly, I have people on my team that are also willing to help too. We're really just like, we want to hire all of you if we can. That's what we're trying.
And as with many scholarships, students always think, oh my gosh, there's going to be so many people that apply that I have no chance. You'd be surprised. There may not be as many applicants as you think there are, and you might have a really, really good shot at it if you just throw your name in the ring. So I'm glad you guys are thinking about it.
Jessica,
and I don't know if this was mentioned because I was distracted there for a while trying to play bouncer to the Zoom room, but I did want to mention, if it wasn't already explicitly talked about, that, you know, part of the reason that this program, or like the reason that this program exists, is because we have big sustainability problems in Indiana, right? We're ranked 49th as the most environmentally friendly state in the country. That is a fantastic, not so fantastic title to have. And, you know, here at IUPUI and at Bloomington and, you know, other campuses, we're training future sustainability professionals, right? And our goal, just to say, is for you to stay here, right? We cannot solve Indiana's problems if we cannot keep Indiana's sustainability professionals here. And how do we do that? Well, ultimately, we're trying to demonstrate to all of these people that you're going to apply to work for. We're trying to convince them that hiring somebody full-time in sustainability is worth it by having you work for them for almost free. And you demonstrating to them the value of them having a student around for 10 to 12 weeks. If they can find value in 10 to 12 weeks, then that can speak to year-round employment, right? Oh, this, if we can get this done in 10 to 12 weeks, what can we get done if we have somebody around all the time? that creates one more job in sustainability, one more organization thinking about sustainability, hiring a student from our university, giving them a full-time job in sustainability so that we can collectively like march this state in the right direction. So like that's like the overall picture of like why this thing exists, is because we've got work to do and we need you all here to get that work done. So we want your talents. We want them to stay here. You can go to San Francisco and Boston, but listen, there you're one of a million. Like here, you're one of 100. And why that can be frustrating, it also means that when you get stuff done, you can point to it and say, I did that. Nobody else, that was me. And there's a lot of like really awesome personal ownership in that.
Thanks for saying that, Jessica. I think too, both Miranda and Jonathan can speak to this too. This program is so unique in that summer, in this experience, you can pull forward a really big project and have it on your resume. And I can tell you from personal experience that like Jonathan and Miranda have stuff on their resume that I didn't have. And some of it I don't even have on my resume, and I'm older than them. And I technically have more years of experience. So you're really getting a huge edge if you do this program. You're just getting such awesome experience and real applied skills, and that you can put on your resume and you can say, I did that. And you can show that to future employers and they're going to be so impressed with you. I'm already so impressed with every student that's done this program. I'm super biased because I hired all of them, but I'm just always amazed at the stuff you guys can do in 10 weeks. It just blows my mind.
Yeah, we have this conversation with Miranda sometimes. Like Miranda, on the days when she has self-doubt, you're 21 years old and you have done a greenhouse gas inventory for the city of Carmel. You're fine. Like nobody has done that by the time they're 21 years old.
I've never like, done that. Are you kidding me? Like what? Yeah, it's crazy.
Literally like whatever, like the fifth biggest city in the state and you've done it for the city of Carmel and you're like, oh, I'm not good enough. Miranda, stop it. You're fine.
We're like
getting attacked. Everyone now knows.
We're attacking you with love.
We all have imposter syndrome too.
That's very common, I think, in our field, which is
frightening. Yeah, but it definitely is. So just to be mindful of your time, it is 3 o'clock. So the webinar has officially ended, but if anyone has any questions or want to stay after and just have like a one-on-one convo with us, you're welcome to stick around if you need to go. Thank you so much for coming. It's so nice to meet you, and hopefully we see you around at the Office of Sustainability. Yeah, have a good rest of your day.
Hope I see your application soon.
What's the deadline again, Danni?
February 19th.
Thank you all very much.
Thanks. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, we'll see you.
I just had a quick question.
Sure.
So I started the application and then I got to the part with the employment where we had to list three employment experiences that we've had. And I had no problem filling out the first two, but the third one, I was having a little trouble just because when in terms of like volunteering, the volunteer stuff I've done is kind of all over the place, not necessarily at one place for a long time. So I don't have a contact, I guess, that would be able to, you know, kind of like be a reliable source. So I was wondering if it is necessary to have three experiences, or if that like would really hurt, or if it like to try to find something for that third spot. So I was just curious to know more about that.
Yeah. Good question. So you could also put, if you've got like a relevant class experience in there, like if you've done a class project or something like that, I think you should be able to submit the application with just the two, I think. But if not, I would think too, like think about, you know, reports you've written or class projects that you've done just to get to that experience. Cause we know, obviously I know that you don't have like 5 years of professional experience. You're a student, right? Like I get that. We're just really trying to see what experience you do have and what skills you might already have. You don't realize. Okay. I'm pretty good at picking things out. So just think about like your other experiences you've had.
Gotcha.
Hi, Jessica.
So then kind of going off of that, this past summer, I got to be part of the climate reality training that happens. So, and then like they train you for, I believe it was like a few days, and then you, all that kind of stuff. So would that work for that employment section?
I would put it on there. Actually, a couple of the ISDP alum from last summer, I think, did the program as well.
Mm-hmm.
So I would actually put that on there. I know it's kind of different in that, like, it's not like an internship and it's not a job, but to me, it demonstrates you have an actual interest. You do have some familiarity with climate and the climate science,
mm-hmm.
you know, and you do have some experience like going through a training, you know, like it just demonstrates interest and that you have related experience, even if it's a little bit different. So I would put that in there. That's actually a good idea.
Okay. Sounds good. Okay. Well, thank you so much.
Yeah. Good to meet you.
Thank you.